everybody.
I'd love to come on here for ages.
Oh, I wanted you to come on for ages. I love that dress.
Thank you very much.
Who designed it?
Just a nice frock. I'm actually going to place a cushion right here because I didn't plan for the sitting down.
I've made you your favourite drink.
What is it?
Martini, isn't it? Is it passion fruit?
Yes. How did you know?
I'm a little bit of a stalker. Is that your favourite drink?
Yeah, my favourite.
Well, I'll join you with it. Look at that.
Looks nice.
Oh, just let it
pour. Looks like orange juice, though, Alan.
Oh, no, it's got a kick, love.
Has it?
Yeah. You'll be having a kebab doing karaoke before you know it. Cheers.
Thank you very much.
Let's have a taste.
Oh.
It's nice.
It actually is passion fruity.
Yeah, yeah.
But it actually is. It does have a good old kick.
I've got a kick.
We've got to talk about the X Factor final.
Right.
I mean, you lost with the girls, lovely Rebecca.
Yeah.
Oh.
I don't think she lost, though.
No, she's a winner, isn't she?
Yes.
And lovely Matt Cardle won. Yeah. Do you reckon he genuinely has got the X Factor? Do you think he can do it?
I think he's one of those acts that you would absolutely love to go and see in this kind of intimate setting.
Yeah.
I do.
Yeah.
I think he's got a good future.
And how was Rebecca afterwards? Was she all right?
She's one of those people that she's just so grateful to be there.
Yeah.
Even, you know, she was like, do you know what, he deserves it and I'm just happy that I was here. She still can't believe that she's in the final.
No, no.
She'll never accept her. She's one of those people.
Yeah. Well, what's going to happen to her? Is she going to bring out, like, an album or...?
Yeah, apparently, yeah. I hear she's got a record deal, so... Yeah. I think she deserves one.
Yeah, I do too. Now, Cher, is it true she's been signed up by will.i.am?
I think there's talk. I mean, I don't dare say anything else, but yeah, there's talk of her working with him, yeah.
Will she change her name to, like, Cher She Is?
I love that.
That's good. Yeah. I think that's good.
That's brilliant.
What was the party like after X Factor finished?
Shoes off, lots of champagne.
Yeah, yeah. Because in my head, I can picture, like, the X Factor after-show party, like, you know, Simon saying, Cheryl, come and join me and Sunita in the hot tub. That's what I imagine it. Is it like that?
It would probably be more exciting if it was. Maybe that's what I should have told you.
Now, is it true that Simon bought all of the panel Botox vouchers for Christmas? Is there any truth in that?
I still have an open mind because I daresn't read that because I will kick off. I've actually given it back, actually.
Yeah.
He could use it.
Without a doubt, this has been the most controversial series of X Factor yet. There's been so much bitching and sniping, especially like in the papers and everything. How much of that is true and...
The first thing I say to my contestants when I get them is don't read into all of that. Don't read the papers. Don't read websites and all of that because they've got to go out on the Saturday and perform and you can get in such a messy headspace.
Yeah.
But in the meantime, we all get caught up in the backstage antics. So, yeah, a lot of it does spill out.
Because, I mean, with Cher and poor old Katie, they really went for them. I mean... Yeah. How did Cher and Katie deal with it? Because they're not even...
Yeah, no, that's what I feel like it's partly my responsibility to keep them in that a positive frame of mind.
Yeah, yeah.
So when you start reading all that badness about yourself, it can drag you down. So we just keep the spirits high. And they did find it really, really tough, and I found it tough to help them see that it was going to be fine.
Because it was just one thing after another. Yeah. I mean, it was...
And when you're not prepared, you know, when you're... Nobody can prepare you for how that feels.
No,
doesn't matter how much they tell you, you kind of have to experience it. But I kept saying to them, you'll never experience this type of craziness again.
Yeah,
so, you know, from now on, it'll just be about you and your record. And your career really starts from when the show stops.
Yeah, and you experienced a bit of a backlash as well in the papers. I mean, do you read it? Does it get to you? Or can you switch off?
I don't read it.
No.
If I did read it, it would probably get to us, yes. But I can't.
Yeah, yeah.
I need to keep that separate.
Mm. obviously with Gamu and everything, that must have affected you.
I don't think I had I didn't really have a long conversation with Gamu. She was very shy, so yeah. I didn't really say that side of her when I made the choice.
Yeah.
When I watched it back, like everybody else, I adored her. Mm. And, you know, I had Will, so I was, like, relying on his eyes as well, fresh, hadn't seen any previous auditions or anything like that.
Yeah.
He chose the exact same three pictures.
Oh, well, there
you go. I was confident and comfortable with my decision, but I would have liked to take all the eight girls through.
Yeah, yeah.
And I loved Gamu. She was cute.
Oh, I know. She was cute. Walking on sunshine.
Oh.
I have to ask you about your relationship with Simon. There's such an unspeakable, unbearable amount of sexual tension between you.
No.
Come
sexual.
On. There is, honestly.
Nothing sexual. Honest to God.
You're whispering each other's ears. He's got his arm round you. He's trying to undo your bra strap. Then you disappear off in the ad breaks. You come back adjusting yourself. I don't know what to think.
Really, is that what it feels like? It's not sexual. We have a lot of chemistry. We do have good chemistry. But honestly, it's not sexual.
Really? Go on, would you take him to deadlock?
No. Would you?
He's got something about him. I think Simon's got something.
He's got charisma.
I mean, and he teases you with that salute, doesn't he? But you do it.
He's very charismatic. I kind of started to do it more towards the end just because I knew it was bothering him so much.
Yeah. Why does it bother him?
Because he feels like I stole it from him. That's what he says.
Oh, I see.
Of course, like everything. You know, Simon's one of those people that when something's good or he likes something, he wants to be involved and take the credit. And when it's not so good, he doesn't want to know about it.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
He's one of those.
You know, you should get him. You know, he got you that Botox voucher. Why don't you get like a penis enlargement voucher and stick it on his foot? That's what I do.
I can't even imagine Simon's. The area. Really, like a wrong shoulder.
Oh, after that, I need a drink.
A stiff one.
You don't want to know the image I've got in my head,
no.
Cheryl. And the X Factor moves to America. Are you doing it? Do we know yet?
Do you know what? I had such a mind full of stuff until Sunday that I haven't even had time to think about it. But who knows?
But have you been asked?
There's been conversations.
Oh, right. Because George Michael might be doing it too, mightn't he? Do you hear about that?
I heard about that as well, yeah.
If he does do it, don't get a lift with him, please. Not to the studio. If you do go to America, will you live there permanently?
Do you know what? It's such a big life-changing thing. I feel like I need time to sit down and think about what I want to do properly, what I mean?
Yeah.
Not just out of X Factor into something. I feel like I need to think about it.
Of course, you missed the start of X Factor this year because of malaria. Now, are you all clear now?
I am.
Yeah.
Yes. Oh, all clear. All good. It's non-reoccurring, so it's done and
it's
gone.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
Because I worried because it's like you hear that once it's in there, but oh, that's good. He's not going to get it back.
Yeah, I'm not going to get
it
back.
Oh, thank God.
It's gone.
Woohoo!
Woo-hoo!
See you, malaria. Yes. Loser. Is it true you actually thought it was like a bad hangover?
I did at first because it was the day after my birthday. And I'm not a big drinker. I don't drink a lot. So it was what I thought was from the vodka.
Yeah. You know gin and tonic beats malaria, did you know that?
Really?
Because it's got quinine in it, do you know about that?
Yeah, quinine's the drug they gave us when I was poorly.
That's in G&T, love.
Really?
I drink so much G&T, I could walk around in my pants going, yeah, mozzies, bite me. Honestly, I could. I love gin and tonic. You should have gin and tonic.
Somebody should have told us that before, maybe.
Yeah, you could have walked around pissed all the time and not got it. You've got to take a break there, Cheryl. Join us again in a couple of minutes when Cheryl and I will be chatting some more. See you in part four.
Welcome back to part four. Look who's still here. It's Cheryl Cole. And you've got changed because you're going to perform again for us later.
Yes.
Fabulous dress.
Thank you very much.
Now, I've got to talk about your new album.
Yes.
It's your second solo album in a year.
I know, it's crazy, isn't it?
Where did you find time to record it?
Actually, some of the songs I had for ages, and I was just bursting to record them. A couple of them I had from the last album.
And you say, like, the first one, Three Words, that was just like a training album. This is really you. This feels like you. Is that right?
Yeah, you just do. You don't think of it like, this is me, and this, it just happens because it is where you're at or what's happening in your life at that moment in time. So it happens like that, so it is you at that moment in time, definitely, yes.
There's a lovely bit in the credits on the album where you thank the girls.
Yes.
I'm assuming that's Girls Aloud and not Loose Women.
Same thing.
Are Girls Aloud ever going to get back together? Have you got any news?
I haven't got any news for
right.
you just yet. But I'll make sure you're the first to know when I do.
And will Nadine be involved as well?
Yeah, of course. Yeah. That's all been blown way out of proportion. Nadine's very much part of Girls Aloud.
Don't look at me like I started the rumours. Now, you're so busy with your career right now. There doesn't seem much time for some something kind of ooh. Has anyone messed with you? Too, too. No, I'm just.
Alan?
No, but I mean, have you had any time for any loving? No. You must be gagging.
No. Alan?
No, I just, you know, you're a woman.
Yeah.
You've got needs. You can't be happy with just two chihuahuas. You need some.
A lady doesn't talk about those things, don't we not? No.
No, but they want to know, don't you? I do know someone who would be interested in you.
Mm.
And I saw him on the telly. Justin Bieber. He said, call me, look at that. How low would you go? Would you... Does he do it for you, the little, lovely little cheeky face and the...
If I was 16.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Do you know what I think? Harry from One Direction.
He's so naughty, isn't he?
I can't believe he whispered in Matt Cardle about him getting locked the money.
I haven't seen it, but I heard.
Well, I was there, you see, because I can lip read. I think, no, I can. My poor deaf friend fell off a stool. I saw him going, honey. And I was like, what? He's a naughty little boy.
I heard it's big on YouTube. I'll have to have a look.
Oh,
that's
yeah.
So naughty.
Yeah.
I'll teach him a big lesson, though, for the
future.
Oh,
I know. What are you doing for Christmas?
Taking some time out.
Well deserved.
We'll meet doggies,
yeah.
Family, Christmas pudding,
oh,
turkey sandwiches.
And everything.
Yeah.
Oh, that sounds
it's
nice.
My favourite time of year, actually. I love Christmas.
Yeah. You look like the woman who's got everything. Is there anything on your wish list that Santa could maybe pop under your tree?
I would actually love to get a puppy.
Another chihuahua?
And I want a big dog that you can roll around with and...
You so need to start dating again, Cheryl.
You don't.
You need to start dating. Get a man, you can roll around the park with a man. You start doing it with a dog, people talk. It's true. You got Simon Cowell singing Dwarfs for his birthday.
Yeah.
What have you got him for Christmas?
Nothing. I'm going to give him his Botox present back.
Yeah, you do it, yeah.
Wrap it up in a bow.
Look at that.
It's brilliant, isn't it?
Do you know what? I bet that will be Louis' category next year. Dwarfs. It's been lovely speaking to you.
Thank you.
I could chat all night, but you're going to perform The Flood for us now.
Yes.
Off you go and get ready.
Thank you very
I'm
much.
I'm so excited. Thank you, Cheryl. Cheryl Cole, everyone!